Hi students, welcome back. In our previous classes, we have learnt areas of plane figures. Areas of plane figures, the complete chapter is based on the formula only. The formulas which we have learnt, that all, once again we can recall it now, we will recall it. What are the plane figures? Square, rectangle, trapezium, rhombus, parallelogram, circle, sector, these are all the plane figures. These all plane figures areas we can find out by using certain formulas for different plane figures. Let us go with all the formulas once again. First plane figure we are called, we take square. From the one we will take square. What is square? Square is a quadrilateral in which all four sides are equal, all angles are right angles. So how do we find the area of the square? Area of the square, we already said that all four sides are equal. So when you multiply side into side, we can get side square. That is how we can find the area of the square. Suppose if a square, all four sides are equal, in which if a side is A, that means all four sides will be A units. In place of A, it can be any number. If one side is A units, remaining all four sides also A units, A units, A units. How do we find the area of the square? Just now I told you, side multiplied by side. That means side into side, side square. That is the formula to find area of the square. Area of the square means the space occupied by these all four sides. When you join the space occupied by these four line segments inside, this space is what? Area. This is known as area. Okay. How do we calculate this place? How much space is occupied by these four line segments? That is the meaning of area of the square. That is the meaning of area of the square. Now we note the side as A. That is why area of this square is A into A square. Otherwise, if you don't name anything as A, B, C, D, simply area of the square is what? Side into side, side square. Enough. Okay. Area means what? The space occupied by this on boundaries inside the space. Okay, this is what area. Now let us write the formula. Area of square. Now this is the square. Okay, ABCD square, whatever the space occupied by four line segments. This is square. Okay. Now area of square. Now if you name it as side, all four sides are equal, in which all are equal. So side into side, that is, you can say that side square. Okay, that is area of square. Next, coming to the next one, rectangle. What is rectangle? Rectangle also one type of quadrilateral in which two pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. So rectangle is like this, and all four angles also right angles. This is equal to this and this is equal to this. So the area occupied, the space occupied by these four line segments, this is what? The area of the rectangle. This is a square. This is rectangle. Okay, this space, okay, the area enclosed by these four line segments, this is what? Area of the rectangle. This is what? Area of rectangle. Now if you name this as length, this and this both are equal. If you name this as breadth, you may call it as width also. Breadth or width, both are same. Okay, in short form, if you name it as L, this as B, or L and W also, width W, okay, however you can call it. Now area of rectangle. Area of rectangle is what? Length into breadth or length into width. Whatever it is. Length into breadth. Or you may call it as width also. So in short form, you can write L into B or LB. Okay? This is area of rectangle. We are not at all discussing about the perimeter here, only the areas. Because our chapter is what? Areas of plane figures. Areas of plane figures. So that is why we are discussing about only the area topic. That's all. Now next, parallelogram. Parallelogram. Area of parallelogram. What is parallelogram? It is also one type of quadrilateral plane figure. So parallelogram. So this is how a parallelogram is like. Of course, rectangle also one type of parallelogram only. But in rectangle, all four angles are right angles. Whereas in parallelogram, need not to be. Now, in this, these pairs are parallel to each other and equal. Two pairs of opposite sides are parallel to each other and equal. Here, the distance, the perpendicular distance between the opposite sides. The perpendicular distance between the opposite sides. This is known as what? Height. Either you can take this one as height or you can take this one as height. The perpendicular distance between the opposite sides is known as what? Height. If you take this as height, this will become base. This will become as base. Okay? Otherwise, if you take this as base, this will this distance between this opposite sides, perpendicular distance between opposite sides, that is also known as height. Now, area enclosed by this, that means the space occupied by this four line boundary. Okay, this is H, the perpendicular distance, right? Now, area of parallelogram. Parallelogram is what? Base into height. Base into height. R is defined as B into H, BH. Okay. What is H? The perpendicular distance between the opposite sides. The perpendicular distance between the opposite sides. If you take this is base, this will become the height. If you take this as base, if you rotate like this, this will become the height. Understand? Now, areas of square, rectangle, parallelogram is over. Now coming to the another type of quadrilateral, that is what? Trapezium. Next one is trapezium. This is also one type of quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. One pair only. Here it looks like this. Here this and this. These two are parallel to each other. Okay? This pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other, but these two are need not to be parallel. These two are parallel to each other. Okay? Then the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides, the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides is known as height. H. You name these two parallel sides which are parallel to each other, name them as A and B. If you name them as A and B, the parallel sides are what? A and B. The perpendicular distance between the parallel sides is what? H. Now, area of the trapezium. Area of trapezium is what? Half into H into A plus B. In this, H means the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides. A and B are what? The lengths of the parallel sides. A is this, B is this. These two are parallel to each other. Their length sum is A plus B. The perpendicular distance between the parallel sides is known as height, H. So multiply with 1 by 2. Half into H into A plus B. This is what area of trapezium. Okay. Now, coming to the next quadrilateral, that is what? Rhombus. Let us discuss rhombus. Rhombus also one type of quadrilateral. In this, it looks like this.
In this also pair of opposite sides are equal, all four sides are equal, rhombus also all four sides are equal. But when we write the area of rhombus, we need not to talk about the size. We will discuss about the diagonals. The diagonals, that means if you name it as A, B, C, D, the opposite vertex, when you join, this is one diagonal. When you join this is another diagonal. You name the first diagonal as D1, the second diagonal as D2. These are the two diagonals. AC is one diagonal, BD is another diagonal. There are two diagonals, they are not equal in the rhombus. They need not to be equal in the rhombus. If they become equal, it will become as a square, of course. That is another thing. No need to discuss that now. In a rhombus, how to find the area of the rhombus? Already told you there will be two diagonals. The diagonals product, half of the diagonals product is what? Area of the rhombus. How to write that? The two diagonals will be denoted as D1 and D2. So, area of rhombus is what? Half into D1 into D2. Here, D1 and D2 are what? Two diagonals of the rhombus. Okay? Diagonal means what? The line joined by two opposite vertices. Okay? The distance between the two opposite vertices is known as diagonal. Okay? Diagonal 1, diagonal 2. Area of rhombus is half into D1 into D2. This you should remember. Now, we discussed about all five quadrilaterals. These all five are plane figures only. Square area of the square, side into side, or you may call it a side square. Area of rectangle, length into breadth, L into B. Area of parallelogram, base into height. Here height means what? The perpendicular distance between the parallel sides. Okay. Here, area of parallelogram, base into height. Next, trapezium. Okay. Trapezium what? In this, one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So, name the parallel sides as A and B. The distance between the parallel sides is height, H. So, area of the trapezium is what? Half into H into A plus B. Right? Next, coming to the rhombus. In rhombus, diagonals. The opposite vertices joined by a line. That is one diagonal. These two, BD. This is also another diagonal. D1 and D2, two diagonals. Area of the rhombus is half into D1 into D2. Here D1 and D2 are diagonals. Now these are all quadrilaterals. Now let us go with the triangle. Okay. Another one is what? Triangle. In which only three sides are there. If that is a right angled triangle. We can name that as one side as base, one side as height, another side as hypotenuse. So otherwise, if it is not a right angle triangle, what about the type of the triangle? If you know the perpendicular distance from the vertex to the opposite side, from any vertex to the its opposite side, perpendicular distance is known as height. Okay? Here if you name this triangle as A, B, C, like that, if you name it A, B, C, here this C opposite side is what? The vertex C opposite side is what? AB. So, if you draw a perpendicular line from this vertex to the opposite side, here, if you name it as D, this is what? H, height. Suppose if you don't want like this, from here suppose, from A, A to opposite side to A is what? BC. From here if you draw a perpendicular line, it is also a height. Otherwise, from B to this, these are all called what? Altitudes. Altitude is nothing but height only. Okay? The perpendicular distance from any vertex to the opposite side is known as the altitude of the triangle. Okay? If you draw like this, this you taken as a height, this will become the base. this will become the base.
So area of the triangle in general we all say half into base into height, but it will not work out for all types of triangles.
When you know base and height, then only you can utilize this formula for all types of triangle. If I take an equilateral triangle, suppose all sides are equal, all three sides are equal. Here height is not given. What is the height of the triangle? What is the altitude of the triangle is not given. Then how do you find the area of that equilateral triangle? There is a confusion. You know only one formula, half into base into height. Then what is the base? What is the height? Not given. Then how? You cannot find the area of triangle? Of course you can find it. But there is another way to find the area of the triangle. Okay?
So now for generally we take area of the triangle formula half into base into height when height is known and base is known. Okay? Area of the triangle, of course it will work out for every type of right angle triangle. Any right angle triangle can be found by using the formula half into base into height. Area of triangle. Okay? Now let us go for another type of triangle. Of course that is not in your syllabus. Area of equilateral triangle, area of isosceles triangle, that is not in your syllabus. Let us discuss that in some other time. Now we go for another in this chapter, areas of plane figures. Another type of plane figures, what are given? Square, rectangle, parallelogram, trapezium, rhombus, triangle. Other than this, circle. Circle is given. Let us discuss area of the circle now. What is circle? The area enclosed by circumference, that means the space occupied by
points which are equidistant from a center point. The space occupied by many points which are all equal distance from a certain point. That point is known as center.
Suppose if I take a point on the plane like this, there are infinitely many points on the plane. There are infinitely many points. But if we choose the points which are equal distance from the point, which are equal distance from a certain point, that area enclosed by the all points which are equal distance from a certain point. That certain point you name it as center.
Okay. The area enclosed by group of points, the area enclosed by the group of points which are all equidistant, you may name it as equidistant from a certain point. All points will have certain distance from one point to another point. From one point on the plane there are infinitely many points. Every point have little bit distance from one point to another point. But if you join certain points which are all equidistant from a certain point, that certain point is known as the center of the circle. The distance from this point to any point is this line. When you join the group of points, a line is formed. Now when this line is enclosed, this has become a circle. That means these are all group of points. There are infinitely many points joining by this line. There is a certain point which is equidistant from these all points. The point is known as center. You take any point on the circular line, that all points are equal distance from the center. So the distance which is there from any point on the circle to the center is known as what? Radius. This distance from center point to any point on circle line, that is known as radius. Okay. Now the area enclosed by this group of points, this is called what? Area of the circle. The space occupied by this group of points which are all equidistant from a certain point. The certain point is center. You may name it as origin also. Okay. It may be determined with O or C. Okay. Origin, or you may call it as center of the circle. The distance from the center point to any point on the circle is known as radius. Again, distance from one point to another point. If you draw a line from one point to another point, if that line is passing through the center, that is known as diameter. Okay, that is known as diameter. there is a relation between the diameter and radius. What is that? Radius is half of the diameter. Otherwise, you may call it as diameter is twice the radius. Twice means double. Okay? What is that? Distance from the center point to any point on the circular line is known as radius. And the distance between any two points on the circular line which is passing through the center point is known as diameter. Okay?
Otherwise, if you join any two points on the circle but not passing through the center from here to here, here also one point, here to one point, if you join this, this is known as what? Chord.
It is not a diameter. It is known as chord.
C-H-O-R-D. Chord. This is not a diameter. But you can draw infinitely many lines like this, joining all the points on the circle line like this. If you join all the points on the circle line, there are infinitely many chords you can draw.
But some lines are passing through the center. The some lines, that means there are lines are called as what? Chords. Some chords will pass through the center. The chords which are passing through the center are known as diameter. The chord which is passing through the center is known as diameter. That is the longest of all.
All chords, you see. Some lines are little length. Some lines are even more bigger compared to one another. Okay? All are different lengths.
Okay? Radius is equal. All radius,
anywhere you draw line like this, all are equal only. Radius is equal.
All radius are equal. But all chords are not equal. Okay? The chords which are passing through the center are known as what? Diameter. Don't confuse. About the chords you will learn in the higher classes in 9th and 10th. Okay? Now we discuss about the diameter only. If I overload also, you'll confuse. Okay?
The chord which is passing through the center is known as diameter. That is the longest chord.
Now, the relation between the radius and diameter only we'll see.
Diameter and radius. This from here, this is a circle. From center point to any point on the circle is what? Radius. Okay? Now, the line which is passing through the center, joining any two points on the circle line, it is known as diameter. Here to here is diameter, here to here is radius. The relation between the diameter and radius. Diameter is equal to twice the radius, that means 2 into radius, or radius is equal to diameter by 2, half of the diameter. Diameter by 2. This is the relation between the diameter and radius. So now coming to the area of the circle. Area of the circle means the space enclosed by group of points which are equidistant from the center point. Okay.
Area of the circle formula. Area of circle is what? Pi r square. What is pi? Pi means 22 by 7. We generally take this 22 by 7. Okay. Pi value is 22 by 7. But not exactly that one. Of course, we use it generally. But exactly we cannot say pi is equal to 22 by 7. Pi means the ratio of the circumference and the diameter of the circle. The ratio of the circumference. What is mean by circumference again?
The boundary line. This line is known as circumference. Okay. That means you can call it as perimeter also or circumference also.
The ratio between the circumference of the circle and its diameter is called pi. But we generally take it as 22 by 7. Okay, the value is 22 by 7.
Remember this pi value. Okay, next r. R means what? Radius. We already know it. Okay, area of the circle formula pi r square. Remember this. That's all.
Next,
part of the circle.
Part of the circle. There are many parts in the circle. Half of the circle. That means
if along with the diameter, if you cut,
the circle will be divided into two equal parts. Okay, each part is known as semicircle. Each part is known as semicircle. Semicircle means half of the circle. Okay, then if you cut the circle like this,
along the two radii. This is one radius, this is one radius. Like this, if you cut a circle in the circle from the center point, radius, if you take this part, if you take this part only, if you take, okay. Now this from here to here, if you cut like this, okay, along with the radii, and this is called what, arc, okay, this is called what, arc. The space enclosed by the arc and two radii is called what, sector. This is what, sector. Here the area enclosed by the arc and the radii is called what, sector. This is small one in size, that is why we call it as what, minor sector. This is what, major sector. This is major part, this is minor part. So sector, you just simply remember sector. Sector means what? Part of the circle which is enclosed by the two radii and the arc. That is what, sector. Here this arc is making certain angle at the center. This angle, we all know, at the center of the circle the angle is 360 degrees. At the center of the circle the angle is 360 degrees. But when you are talking about this sector, this arc is making certain angle at the center point. So that angle, if you denote with x, letter x, x degrees. Okay. In the complete circle, the angle is 360 degrees. Now, to find out the area of the sector, the angle made by this arc at the center and the two radii are what? Radius. Okay. Now, area of sector is what, x degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square. This you should remember. Area of sector formula, x degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square. Okay. Here x means the angle made by the arc at the center. R means radius. Okay. This is one formula. There is another formula also for finding area of the sector. LR by 2. What is L? Length of the arc. If angle is not given, suppose if angle is not given, length of the arc is given. That means this is length of the arc. This one. From here to here. This arc is making certain angle. If the angle is not mentioned in the question, suppose angle is not given, x degrees how much, it is not given. Then how? Then the length will be available. Length of the arc, that is denoted with L. Then radius is available, R. So another formula is what? Area of the sector. Area of sector is what? LR by 2. But again, length of the arc how to find? Okay. If you use this formula, length of the arc formula again, x degrees by 360 degrees into 2 pi R. L is equal to length of the arc. Length of arc, it is denoted with the letter L. Here x degrees by 360 degrees into 2 pi r. 2 pi r is what? Circumference of the circle. That is the boundary line. This is circumference. We are taking one part. Little part we are taking it from the circumference. That is what? Length of the arc. Okay. These are all the formulas which are required to solve the problems of our plane, areas of plane figures. This is very, very, very important topic. All formulas we have recovered from the chapter. In the chapter, there are two exercises. All different formulas are, questions are there. In that questions, we are going to find the areas of different types of plane figures. Starting from the square, rectangle, parallelogram, trapezium, rhombus, triangle, circle, sector. Okay, right? I hope you all understood. Recall all the formulas noted down in a single paper. Every day you spend at least 5 minutes to recall all these formulas. These are very, very helpful in your coming up classes also. Okay, don't forget them. Hope you all understood all the formulas and the notations. Notations means in the formula. Now this formula, what, x degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square. What is mean by x? The angle formed by the arc at the center. The angle.
Okay, r means what? Radius. Pi means what? 22/7. These all things you should know. Here in this, diameter and radius. The relation between the diameter and radius. Diameter is twice the radius. That means double the radius, you will get the diameter. Half the diameter, you will get the radius. This you should remember. Area of the square circle is pi r square. Area of the sector is x degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square. If not, if this is not available, then how to do? Lr by 2. Here L is what? Length of the arc. Length of the arc. This you should remember. Hope you all understood today's class. Thank you very much. In the coming classes, we will do the solutions. Thank you very much.